Hey guys, it's me Paige and welcome to another video and welcome to part 2 of this high school advice video. So if you did not watch part 1, you should go watch it unless you do not really are interested, because part 1 of my high school advice video is me talking about the overview of high school, which is a lot of questions for incoming freshmen and what my opinions about high school are. So if you are here from the first video, hi, thank you for watching part 1. And in this video, we're going to be talking about all the tea about high school. So really about the relationships, my opinions about relationships in my past, and a lot of friendship and a lot of cliques and a lot of bliggy blaggy about high school. There's a lot that's gonna be in this video, so grab your snack, grab your smoothie, and let's just head into these questions. How to make friends. Making friends in high school for the first time is pretty easy. It's either being partnered with them, it's either being put in a group project with them, it's either joining a club, or just people in your homeroom if you have one. I think, in my opinion, I have had a lot of friends more because of my homeroom, because every morning, not a lot of schools do homeroom, but in my homeroom, we stay there for like 10 minutes, and then that's how I ended up being friends of a lot of people. And I honestly think making friends is pretty easy in high school, so I don't think you really need to worry about that. How to deal with friendships ending or losing friends and getting back on your feet. That's a lot, actually, in one question. So how to deal with friendships ending. First, I'm just going to talk about those friendships you've had for a long time. So when you get in high school and you are in friendships that you were since elementary and middle school, it's okay, really, to lose them, because friends do change a lot in high school. There's a whole deeper meaning of why you lose friends in high school, but honestly, you lose friends in high school for the better of yourself, and you should gain friends that make you feel happy with yourself and not feel like you need to do stuff for them. And how to get back on your feet. I feel like you will be okay. There is no such thing as just, you will cope over losing and ending friendships, but the thing is, you really need to do this for the better of yourself. And like I said in my last video, self-care is the key to everything in high school. And honestly, I think you'll be okay either or without these toxic friends in your life. How do you have time to keep up with drama and still get things done? I hate that question. I have nothing against the person that asked that question, but the thing about that question is
drama should not be your priority in life.
And I hate people that say that just get away from drama. Drama will always be surrounding you in high school. But the thing is about drama, do not input yourself into that drama in any type of way. If you are involved in the drama, just let it go. Do not talk about it. Do not talk about the drama with anyone. You can talk about it with your close cousins or like close family friends. That's the people who I trust the most. And honestly, you will always be surrounded by drama. You should focus on your school. Do not input yourself into drama situations that you have no involvement with. If you hear people talking about drama to you, just don't say anything that will be against you, really. And it sounds very selfish, but you should care more about your school than drama. How to nicely drop your middle school friends. What I like to say to that.
That's a lot of tea right there.
And second of all, I think that over time, you don't really need to drop them, because you will always end up having to hang out with different people all the time, and you will not always be surrounded with those same people in middle school. It's okay to start off with your middle school friends, but eventually you guys part your own ways. That's what I ended up doing during freshman year. By the first semester, I was hanging out with my middle school friends, and then by the second semester, I ended up having a more close type of group of friends, and those are honestly still one of my closest group of friends till today. There's a lot of people in high school, but starting off with those close group of friends from middle school, it is okay, and honestly, it feels like a little safe net. So start off with them, and then making new friends in high school, you will branch out in your own way, so it's okay. Is it really like a movie where there are cliques and they always have the mean ones? Yes. Kind of yes and kind of not. So cliques. Cliques are something, like I like to say, I wish it doesn't exist, but cliques actually do exist in high school. What I'd like to say, high school is not a movie. High school seems so perfect in movies. The real thing is high school is very the whole exaggerated part is kind of what high school is, in which there are cliques. There are the jocks, or there's the cheerleaders. There's always going to be cliques. But the thing is, there's no such thing as, like, cliques can't mix with other cliques. Like, I hang out with people that do sports all the time. I hang out with people that are in band. I hang out with people that are in the math team. I hang out with a lot of different type of people, but there's no such thing as just cliques cannot mix. That's the only thing. This is not the song from High School Musical that sticks to the status quo. It is not that type of thing. And the thing with the mean ones, the movie Mean Girls, there are girls like that in high school. The thing is, there are a lot of type of girls like that in high school. They'll be the ones that will actually talk crap behind your back while you're there, or there's going to be ones that just talk crap about you, but don't really want to confront you with it because they don't want to start drama or anything. The thing is, with these whole cliques in high school thing, I don't think you should care about them, and you should care about yourself more. Like, I honestly said that a million times in this video, but you really should not care about the cliques, and you should not care about popularity. You should not care about the mean girls. Do not become a mean girl so you can just be popular. Who cares about popularity? It's just high school. You are not gonna get a diploma for being popular.
Amen.
How to handle a breakup in general in high school. I had to deal with a breakup in high school actually once with someone that was in my high school. So, high school relationships are very complicated, like I say. Not a lot of people actually count their high school relationships. I don't know how I count them in my brain right now. But yes, I can say I gone through a really bad breakup in high school. And honestly, how you deal with it, it's okay to cry, it's okay to be upset. Just don't make it affect your school, and that's all I can say. It did affect my school a little when I got on my breakup, but the thing is, you should not care about the whole thing, because a lot of drama will come out once you guys break up in high school, because high school is really what it says in the movie, once someone knows, everyone knows. It is pretty true with that. I honestly think that once you get in your breakup, you just need to be a strong person, and you just need to be the bigger person and just move on with your life. It's okay to be upset, and I honestly think that breakups in high school will just help you find yourself more, and I think it will make you a stronger person. I honestly think a lot of relationships in high school are meant to happen so you can find lessons in them. What's the easiest way to stay out of trouble and away from people who are not the best? The thing with that entire situation is that you should not care about what your friends, your ex-friends will think once you drop them. You have to drop people in high school for yourself. If you don't want to get involved with the whole druggy thing, then don't hang out with those people that do drugs. Everyone in high school, I can say, will do drugs at a point. I have never done drugs before because of medical things, but I personally think I have been surrounded with people that do drugs, and all I can say is that once they're in that situation, when they want to do drugs, I just softly, like, just walk away. Even if they say anything, I still walk away. You just need to not care, really, because your friends, those are not real friends that will force you to do many things. How to remove someone from your life without creating drama, and how to remain calm during this hectic time. I'm gonna talk about, because along with this question before that, they asked how to remove toxic people from your life. I personally had to do this in the past. It is the hardest thing I had ever had to do, and it took me 5 months to actually do it, because I don't like dropping people and I don't like being mean. But the thing is, I needed to confront that person and confront them with how they made me feel. And if they don't agree, the person that I confronted did not agree, it's okay if they get mad at you, but the thing is, they shouldn't threaten you, they shouldn't make you feel uncomfortable, they shouldn't physically harm you in any other way. And I honestly think how to remain calm during this, you need to talk to your closest friends. You need to talk to someone you really do trust, and I think, in my opinion, someone that's been there for you for a long time during past experiences of harm that was happening to you will be your best source of who will be there for you for a long time. I honestly think if you are going through this process of removing some of the toxic from your life, I wish you well, and honestly, it is for the better of yourself, and I am proud that you are stepping up for yourself, and you will be okay in the end, and it is very rewarding. How to not be scared for a relationship. I have not been in a long relationship before with anyone. I think you just need to be confident with yourself. And a lot of people, I'm gonna say this for just the girl perspective.
Girls, if you want to ask out this guy, ask out the guy.
Trust me, if you like the guy, tell the guy you like him. It is okay. This is okay. It is not the movies all the time, and the guys sometimes will not confess their feelings for you because they're waiting for you. And honestly, from past experience, I never really tell guys I like them, but I have told at least one guy, like in the couple past month and year, that I like them. And it was honestly pretty rewarding because, you know, they might like you back too. So I think you need to be more confident with yourself, girls. And if you're a guy and you're watching this video, hello, hi. If you like the girl, ask her out. If she makes a move on you, it's okay. Girls who are confident, I feel like guys like them more because they're more upfront, really. And I really like guys that are okay with girls being upfront and confident. No one is really ever ready for a relationship, but all I can say is that it is okay to be nervous. You will be okay. So this is the end of the video, and I hope you guys like these two videos about me talking about high school. I am so happy that I am doing a type of advice video. I've been wanting to do an advice video, but I was waiting for me to go into junior to actually make this video because I already have 2 years of experience of high school. So I might be doing another high school related video coming up soon. I am not sure, but I hope you guys like this video, and I don't really know what to say. I don't have any scrunchies on me, but goodbye.